Everybody's rocking with Chewy on Charlotte's new hip-hop station, Streetz 103.3.
Streetz 103.3, Charlotte's new hip-hop station. You're now tuned into the Voice of the Streetz, and I have some special guests from the West Coast in the building. Go ahead and let them know who I got in here.
Hey, you already know what it is. This Jay and Fresh in the building. What's poppin'? You already
poppin'? Know, man. How many times y'all practice that?
Hey, man, it's like sometimes it be on accident.
Sometimes, like, I'll be just saying, like, yo, what's up? It's Jay and Fresh, and then he'll be in the background, like, it's Jay and Fresh. I don't know. It depends.
Like they said, ladies and gentlemen, Jay and Fresh are in here all the way from the West Coast. Go ahead and let them know where from the West Coast y'all repping.
Man, we from the Bay Area. California. Richmond, California.
You already know. We just came all the way out here, you know, doing this promo run. But, man, you know, California is where we from. Palm trees, beaches,
Richmond.
All that.
What a lot Richmond. Of people don't know is, correct me if I'm wrong, Coach Carter.
Yeah,
that's the original home of Coach Carter. Yeah. A lot of people think it's Richmond, VA, but it's actually Richmond, California. That they're talking about Coach Carter.
Yep.
Yeah, that was a crazy season Rich for City. The dude.
What was it like growing up in California for you guys?
I mean, I guess it was just normal, you know, because I ain't never really just been out of Everywhere California else. So many times unless we was doing music. So, I mean, it was just home, you know.
Well, like, now that you're traveling more, what have you noticed that was different growing up there than other environments?
Man, we definitely was blessed with cool weather. That's one thing. And yeah. I mean, I don't know. It's like everywhere has been cool. Like
the music, the culture, like home. You get to see the different cultures definitely. And how people are brought up.
The
like,
accents,
especially
crazy.
Coming to the south.
Yeah,
coming to the south to the West Coast is completely different.
It's a lot of hospitality.
Being on the road, late nights. Man.
Yeah, I'm telling you, you mentioned hospitality in the south. I was out in LA for BET weekend, and I tell you this. L.A., they were cool, but they was like, yeah, I don't really want to talk to you. Just keep doing what you're doing. Everybody was on the go.
Yeah, that's kind of how it that's kind of how it's like it this way.
It's kind of like New York. Like, you know, it's like people like, they, you know, they not really.
A more peaceful New York, you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's like because everybody got something to do. So it's like, I mean, you know, they'll mess with you, but it's like they so on their time. They got to get here, got stuff to do. That's so they just fast pace out there.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the music. Let's talk about behind the music before we talk about it. Let's talk about how both you guys linked up and got into music.
Well, actually, we both brothers. So, yeah, I mean, brother. Since day one, we've been both doing music like separately. And then we finally became a group when we was like 13. But I mean, since like 8 years old, we was rocking. So.
Man, just been in the music ever since.
Now, who has been some of your biggest influences growing up?
Definitely my dad, Sam Bostic, being in a household of music, him doing music for E-40 and Tupac and stuff like that. It was like always right there for me. But then like definitely a bunch of other artists like Kanye and E-40 and just like this goes on the people.
Growing up in my household, it was like Tupac, like me and my brothers. I always mention it. Like, you know, we listen to Bones. You know, that's what was coming up. And then, you know, it's just like I listen to a lot of different music. I'm like, you know, listen to the Bay Area, like E-40, like all of them coming up. But then I also listen to the radio, you know, especially just to stay up to date. So it was like my musical background is a mixture of a lot of stuff. You know, I can't really just pinpoint just three or four artists. It's like I listen to everybody.
Yeah.
Now, for the people who don't know, name something about yourself that a lot of people may not know about you.
Lil J. You feel me? The name speak for itself. But for some reason, people like, they see like our CDs and our posters and stuff. And then when they see me, they be like, man, I thought you was going to be taller than what you was. So,
now, I'm not going to lie. I ain't the world's tallest man or nothing. But I was like, yo, I was expecting him to walk in here and be like, damn, 6'4". You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm the 6 footer.
Yeah. So what about you?
Who, me? Like a lot of people just... I'm quiet, even though a lot of the time, like, you'll see me, like, real turned up. Like, I'm like, laid-back person. I'm, like, real chill. A lot of people just, you know, really kind of just see me acting up. But a lot of people don't know. I'm just laid-back, dude, chill.
So let's talk about how you guys linked up with E-40 and got the song together.
Man, it was crazy. We was actually in L.A. doing, like, a little promo run out there promoting the original song, the actual Catting Off single. And, like, we was about to head out to go host at this event, and he had called us at the hotel.
And you know how E-40, he be talking.
Now, if you could do an impression of his voice.
Let me see.
How would it go?
I could only hit the
No, he was just like, because, well, originally he wanted
that's all like,
how would go?
Ooh.
That's originally he wanted another song.
He got too many.
So he had called, and he actually called our manager. So he had called us in the room. He was like, you know, somebody want to talk to y'all. So we get on the line. He's like, hey, yo, what's happening? You feel me? Like, what's going on with y'all? We like... oh, what's up, what's up? He was like, yeah, you know, I was just listening to that Cat North record, you feel me? And I was just feeling that. I wanted to just let y'all know I'm going to drop my verse on that as soon as possible. I'm just like, man, trying to really understand what he's saying.
When a legend like that co-signs off on you, you know what I mean? That goes to show you that, like I always say, the work is getting done.
Yeah, definitely.
You know what I mean? The work is definitely getting done when you have a legend stepping out to reach out and contact you.
I feel like we definitely on the right path because, like I was saying, we originally was, you know, wanted him to get on something else, but and then we just released that song, and he called us like, that's the one I want to get on right there. So it's like, oh yeah, this is.
He's definitely been like watching because we've talked to him in the past, and he like let us know like I'm watching y'all grinding, and then like out of nowhere he was just like, okay, I'm on that. So like to us it like kind of shows us he don't just do stuff for anybody like just out of the blue. So when he reached out and did that, it kind of showed us too like, all right, we definitely on the right track to where we need to be. So it was like confirmation for us to just keep grinding and keep working harder.
Not only that, it's like sort of in an aspect a fan aspect, you know what I mean? Being a fan of yours, you guys'
definitely.
Music, you know what I mean, and supporting you guys, for someone like that in that standard to say, hey, I'm gonna keep up with you guys, not even say it, but to do it.
Yeah,
because like, you get a lot of people who will talk it
all the time. Man. We didn't rent, man, so many people like that. Like, it was like Big Sean was just talking about that. It was like a little clip on Instagram. He's just like, man, it's like a lot of people in this industry is just like so fake. Like sometimes like they say they're going to do this or do
and
that.
They never
and then
do
like,
it
never happened. But it's like, that's
so for the fact that he's like done it and followed up. It's like, that's dope.
And the video, you know, it was
he did
no
the video
problem.
Too.
Yeah, we got the
no
video
problem.
Right
it was
now.
Like, he was let me know when it is.
Man, he came through. He had all types of bottles with him.
He had his
Earl Stevens, and then he had the slur cane. He was in there trying to get us super wasted at the video. Like that was his.
That's
job.
The only way to do it, though. Man, if you gotta do something, might as well let it be legendary. Yeah, something like that.
Everybody at that video shoot definitely is gonna remember that day.
Yeah,
forever.
It was
like it was a dope video
all day.
Yeah, and then like we had a few like cool little names like Vine Superstar, this dude named Ronnie Banks, the bro, and then Team Money, Team Skater, Lil Rome Diddy. He's like,
man,
well, how old is he? Like five.
I bumped into him. He short dude, long hair. Right?
Yeah,
I bumped into him out in LA. Can he really skate?
Yeah, he's dope. Like that dude. Like when we was in Vegas, when we met him, like with him and his pops, like literally every day he's at the skate park in the rain,
just
going hard. And we actually met his dad like 2 years before he really blew up.
In Sacramento,
they stay like in the Sacramento area, and we was at the mall, and he was like passing out little flyers for him, and I seen it, and I think he was like 2 at the time, and I'm like, dang, that's dope, like he really grinding, like that's hecka tight, and like three years later, it's like
blew up,
money
part
team.
Of Team Money Team with Mayweather all the time, traveling, like he's doing his thing right
and
now.
Then
now
and then he made a video, actually how we got him in the video. Because we was in Vegas, we ran into him, but his dad actually put the Cat Off song behind one of his little Instagram posts. Got like 5,000 likes and all that. So when we seen him in Vegas, we was like, hey, like, you know, that was our song. He was like, oh, I mess with that song. I slap that song all the time.
And
so
then it's hecka funny because like Lil Rome is just like so young, he don't even really
know
what's
going on.
And he's like just meeting us like, oh yeah, that's what's up. Like, cool, I'm finna eat this burrito and we chillin'. I got this skateboard. Like, you feel me? Like, it's
now,
crazy.
With you guys being so young in the industry, you guys starting off young, I know you mentioned that your dad definitely has musical background influences on that. You know, do you guys see the business side of it more so than the actual artist side, or do you balance off both?
We definitely balance it off.
Yeah,
we definitely do that. Cause what? before my dad started even working with us, like on the manager stuff, like he was like, basically y'all just handle y'all music stuff. Like when it's time, like I'm gonna work with y'all. So like, and every time we doing something, like he tries to coach us through it so that we understand what's going on, rather than just doing the music, putting out the song, having the single, and getting ready for the campaign. It's like we know every step to our radio campaign. We know the stations. Like we really getting into
the
business.
You know
the
targets that you want to hit.
He don't just handle the business and then
tell us what's going on.
Because
and show us
the
results.
Because you get a lot of artists who don't necessarily care for doing the radio, don't really care for even knowing what's going on about them and stuff, where they just want to see a check.
But just to let all artists know, that's important.
Yeah, it's definitely that's a big step to this industry. Like, it's called the music business for a reason. So, like, to know this industry and the business is, like, very important.
Now, with everything going on, the Meek Mill versus Drake going on, that's right now the hot topic.
Man, we was just talking about that yesterday.
Gotta ask you. And I don't want to put you on the spot, but I gotta ask you, who you rocking with, Meek or Drake the most?
Man, I can't pick out of them. I rock with both of them, man. Like, I really do. I can't even choose sides. I mean, how I feel, I would say, like, Meek Mill shouldn't have really just kind of aired him out like that. I would say, like, they could have had a personal conversation on what's going on with the album, but I can't choose a side.
Yeah, that's kind of, like, touchy right there. Because, like, I mean, it's a lot of artists that ain't writing stuff in the industry. So
definitely.
So, I mean,
it's a business.
I ain't really the one to judge. So, like, he doing his thing. Like, that's all I can really respect is he making his money, he grinding, he's doing his thing. Meek is just doing it another way. But I definitely, like he said, like, the whole going and blasting it out there, like, I wasn't really
feeling
it.
A little bit too much, a little bit extensive.
Like, they know each other too close. He could have texted him, and they could have had, like, a personal conversation about it, like, this is how I feel, and then it would have been like, all right, at least I know that. So if you don't feel like working with him no more, then just leave it at that. But
I feel exactly the same way that both you guys just feel. I don't know. Maybe it's just our generation that looks at things a little bit differently.
Probably.
You know what I mean?
Once you really get into the industry, you're gonna know that a lot of these artists really, really don't write a lot of their music now, you know, lyrics versus, you know, they do, but like hooks and hit songs, like
a lot of people
check the credits, like, man, you'll see, like,
and that's what one of my friends did. He made a valid point. One of my friends pulled it up for me. He was like, man, check Meek Mill's credit.
Yeah, he got people that was writing stuff on his albums too. Yeah, so like, it's like,
I mean, he may write his.
Everybody's doing the same
but
thing.
But I think the real issue, like we was talking about, it wasn't the fact that it was a song; it was a verse. Like as a rapper, like that's you.
Yeah,
like that's how you feel. That's your swag. That's your style. So like when you rapping a verse, that's what people want to like know you by. Like the hook is that catchy part that grabs the attention, but the verse is like what's really killing it. So like, for you not to write your verses on songs is different, because then it's kind of like a cheat code, like, oh, you're not even doing nothing.
Now, this would be my next question to you guys.
Yeah.
A lot of artists face it. What is your biggest fear in the entertainment industry and why?
Not being able to stay consistent. Like, that's one thing you have to do in this game is be consistent and actually stay above water, because it's a lot of times where you can just, some people, they'll make a hit song, they'll drop their album, and then they're like, oh, I did my thing. I'm hot. You know what I'm saying?
Then 5-6 months go by, and then it's like, that's that next artist right behind
you. You got 2 or 3 artists ahead of you.
So, like, that's the biggest thing is to always stay in the studio and just, like, keep ourselves humble enough to know, like, we got to rock with everybody out there and just keep pushing, so.
You know this industry is crazy, so I just really want to be able to maintain my humbleness and all of that. I know it's going to be crazy, but.
Definitely, definitely. Let's talk about the music video. What was that experience like for you guys? I know you talked on E-40 bringing the drinks, but I know it looked like you guys have fun.
It was a 23-hour shoot.
It was fun, but it was long. We woke up at like 2 o'clock in the morning, started at like around 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. And at first, the weather was bad. Like it
was
raining and it was bad.
Court.
And we was almost like, dang, like, what are we going to do? Because it's like this summer song, so we wanted it to be, like, bright and
summertime
stuff.
Summertime vibes.
Yeah, so it's like we got rain and girls out there in shorts trying to dance. It's like, man, it's not going to work. But eventually it switched over, and then it was cool. It was just a long shoot. We had fun, though. There was a lot of people that came out, a lot of models and stuff. Shouts out to all them for coming through. But it was dope.
Now, what do you guys see next for yourself outside of the music business? Outside of music business, you see a lot of artists going to doing movies. You see them going into clothing. What do you guys see yourself falling into if that time comes where you say, all right, I want to put music aside and find something else?
Yeah, I definitely like to branch out in the design. You know what I'm saying? Especially in the movies. Like, I'm a great actor.
You're retarded. We actually been talking about like putting together like some type of movie with my dad's friend Mike Mosley, the producer as well for E-40. He's been doing like a bunch of projects, and we've been talking to him about trying to put together like a little movie, kind of like introducing ourselves and
showing
our culture and how we was.
Now in the movie, would it be some type of house party?
Yeah, it'd be like a new house party. New generation house party.
I wouldn't really say like a new house party because like, I mean, it would be turnt for sure. But like, we like one thing about us, like we don't just do party music. Like Catting Off, like you could play it in the clubs, people could dance to it and that type of stuff. But we have other music like featuring our brother Dreski B called Die For This. And it's like, we just
Dreski B, what up?
We just going in, you feel me? And like really like telling our struggle and talking about like the stuff we've been through, and it's like on a trap beat, and we got like trap music and like all type of stuff. So it's really gonna just be like it is gonna have those turned up parts, but then at the same time we want to show people so that they could kind of feel the struggle that we went through coming up in the industry. So
now, who are the top 5 artists outside of you guys that you listen to in your phone right now?
Kanye, Young Thug, Rich Homie, definitely. I listen to E-40 a lot still. And then definitely I Am Sue in the Bay. Shouts out to the HBK gang. Yeah, they doing their thing right now.
Yeah, that's basically because we listen to the same music, you know what I'm saying? We're like, just, you know, just basically less good music. Like, it's not really, I don't really just turn down any artist. Like, if you got a great song, I'm going to slap that.
The music speaks for itself.
Yeah, basically.
Now, do you ever find yourselves when y'all traveling and people pick up on your language? People pick up on your terminology, on how your slang goes?
Because yeah, I picked up on it. We was just talking about that earlier.
You're saying slap, and I'm like, never heard of that lingo before.
It's like banging, you know?
Yeah, like
you
it's, know, like however you would say, you like a song is like.
Turn.
Yeah, like that slap. Like,
yeah, a lot of people get on our lingo all the time, because like, especially being from the Bay, like, we say boy for everything. So it's like, we call a girl boy, like, boy, shut up. Like, you feel me? So it's like, I ain't no boy. Like, little girl, you shut up. You feel me?
Now, but, for the people who don't know, how old are you guys?
We both 22.
22. Yeah. How many tattoos you got?
I honestly don't know.
Stop counting.
I ain't been tripping off of it.
Now, I ask a lot of people that have tattoos, such as Ty Dolla $ign, what is your favorite tattoo? So, in your case, what would be your favorite tattoo?
I got a tattoo, like, in the middle of my arm. The bird, it's like a bird made out of music notes, and it's basically like just to like express like my freedom with music, like overall in the industry. Like, I don't know, cause like our style, like even photo shoots and videos and stuff like that, like we try to really like make ourselves just out there. Like, we don't really have like a box that we put ourselves in as far as our style and our music.
Yeah, like, we're willing to go, you feel me? I mean, you know, we're not gonna just go crazy outside the box, but we're not afraid to try new stuff.
Nor should you be. Man. But check it out. We're about to go live right quick. Streetz 103.3 exclusive right now. And we got to let the people hear your music.
Streetz 103.3, Charlotte's new hip-hop station. That was that song right there by the homies Jay and Fresh. Hey. Song called Catting Off. You know where you hear all the new music. Like I said, homies, go ahead and tell the people one time while no music is playing in the background. Of course, y'all Instagram it.
They can add us on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, anything on social media at Jay and Fresh, JayNFresh. And the video right now is on YouTube featuring E-40. We got a few other music videos you can check out. The EP just dropped last Tuesday.
Check that out.
Everybody can just check out
iTunes,
more music.
iTunes, Amazon,
Google Play.
Download it all on all sites.
Everything. And when you hear this single, when you hear Catting Off on the radio, when he play it here, y'all Shazam it. You could buy it off of there too. It'll take you everywhere you need to buy it. Watch the video.
Don't you just love the young business mind? Shazam it. He threw in the plug for it all.
Already know, man.
But Jay and Fresh is in the studio. They got to be in the city all way until Monday, man. Hey, we got to chop it up more with them. Y'all keep it locked right here on Charlotte's new hip-hop station, Streetz 103.3.
Hey, man, you already know what it is. It's Jay and Fresh.
And you already know we rocking out in Charlotte, Streetz 103, man. So keep it locked on Bug TV, man. Turn up.